So I think we can both agree that if we were going back to college, these are must-haves for your Google Chrome, basically.
Exactly. Like, I can't believe how much I slept on having just extensions for all kinds of different things. I really hate how I only maybe had one or two when I could have had like 6, 7, 8, 10. First, the main goal and the main message that we have, use Chrome extensions.
Yeah,
they
please.
Are free.
Yes, you're missing out.
Yeah, they are free. Of course, you can access a lot of premium features if you pay, and that's nice. But what you can get for free for in a Chrome extension is really something that a lot of different, not only college students, but people overall just sleep on. And we are here to basically break that, destroy it.
Yeah, just in case. I'm still using like most of this today.
Yeah, I know that the first entry is like your lifesaver.
Yeah, I got tired of recommending this app.
And actually, you recommended it to me because first we're going to start with a note-taking app. We all take notes, either it's for college or for work or like for even your life. And it's very easy to use Evernote, use Notion, use your notes app on your iPhone. And Matty came out of nowhere and said like, no, Santi, this is what you need to do.
Yes, Milanote. God.
Milanote.
I got tired of recommending it for real because it's like, I remember finding this app. I don't even remember when. I remember I was watching a YouTube video, but I don't remember which one. And I was like, I have to try this app. I have to try it out. And it's just so intuitive.
No.
It's just so
and
intuitive.
And they should pay you because so far you have like brought like 5 people.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a referrer by this point. I should be associated with them, definitely. I have it on my phone right now. Like, it's literally it's a lifesaver for me. But yeah, it basically takes notes, just so everyone that doesn't know.
But what makes it so different? I mean, come on, you need to be more.
Well, wait, yeah, because you have Evernote, you have Notion, you have all these different apps. What I think makes Milanote special is that it's super intuitive for anyone that's starting out with maybe a note-taking app. Maybe they just don't even feel comfortable using the note apps on their iPhones. So they're just like, I need something that it's intuitive, that can help me with different tasks in my life. Because sometimes you're just using notes for school or you're just using notes for like cooking recipes. Okay, so Milanote has integrations for that as well. So it has different templates for all the notes that you can have. You can draw on it, which I know you do. I don't find myself using it, but you use it.
I just love using all those arrows going from one place to the other. I need them. Like, I am that visual. I need that.
Well, I am a color coding kind of freak. Every color means something.
No, I know. But again, it really speaks on all the different levels and ways that you can use
it. And it's
Milanote.
Free.
And it's free.
It's free. You don't have to pay for it. And you have like 100 tabs.
Yeah. Yeah. And you think that also if you send your referral code to a friend, then you get like an extra card and tabs that you can use. So
yeah, that's true.
Like just like you did it with us, you can do it with a friend. Like try it out, just send it. And trust me, just try, again, all of these apps are free. So
yeah.
Try them. If you like them, you can thank us in the comments. And if not, then you can go back to the comment and say, hey, actually, this app was rubbish.
Yeah, and now something that I think it's interesting, it's we're going to basically uno reverse this. And we're going to talk about an app that you recommended to me. And then now I am in love with this app.
I know it is a great app. We've talked about taking notes, but it's also very important to save time, not only to save your notes. See what?
Nice one.
And overall, so far, of course, there are a lot of time management on track your time, on set your goals and everything. But if you are a reader and you like things, like reading things, Speechify is a Chrome extension. It's an app that you should definitely use. It's a text-to-speech converter from it, and you can integrate it, again, of course, the Chrome extension, but it also has an app. It also has a desktop version, and it syncs across all the different devices, so you can just paste a PDF, a book. It synchronizes with your Kindle even. And from there, you just hit play, and you have anything you give it, it's going to read it with a very high quality voice. And recently they added Mr. Beast, they have Snoop Dogg, Gwyneth Paltrow, they have Cliff Weisman, who is
one of the best voices by far.
One of the best voices is also Speechify's founder, so you can see why it's one of the best. But truly, it's very high level. And what I'm really trying right now is playing with the speed. Because my first time using Speechify was like, I'm not going to need it for more than 1.5 speed. And then I started using it more frequently, and out of nowhere, I got to increase it little by little. Like, okay, so now it's 2. Now it's 2.5. And now I'm reading at 3x speed, which is crazy. And I feel like I'm getting to understand everything. And because it has a Chrome extension, you just have the tab right there. You hit play, and it automatically starts reading everything. Now, of course, it's not perfect every time. There might be some different sentences or structures that, you know, the voice isn't getting 100% correctly, but it's 99% correctly.
Yeah, it's not an issue when you're using it 100%.
Exactly, most times. And if you're going to use it for, you know, papers, academic research papers, and it has citations, the desktop version has an option that you can basically choose to skip all of this.
Yeah,
and
that's
it saves
true.
You a lot of.
I've used it for research papers.
I remember, like, a few years ago, we tried Speechify initially, and I think it didn't have this option. And maybe you were just reading, and out of nowhere, 2024 at all. I was like, no, what is this? It's completely new rambling, and now you can skip it. So it's great. It's an amazing feature. It's an amazing app. You should try it.
And how satisfying is it when you're like watching the time left that you need to hear, and then you up the speed and it just goes way smaller.
Oh.
Like it's way shorter, and you're like, oh God, yes. Like, you can see how you're saving time. I think that's the difference. Like, you can actually see how you're saving the time.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Like, when I use it on my phone to read books, and then maybe I'm going to start the day and like, okay, this week you have saved 10 hours. Like, what? 10 hours of reading time. You know how many things I was able to do in those 10 hours. So we talked about taking notes. We talked about saving time. It's time we talked about how to write better.
Which is key.
Very important. Not only for college, if you're an old student, but basically for anywhere.
I
on
use
everything.
This one for emails a lot.
Let's introduce it. And I think it's clear that we are going to talk about Grammarly here in this channel. We are huge fans of Grammarly. We use it for like always, like with five, six years. I found Grammarly when I joined the Great Hacker, so you can see how old the Grammarly is in our team and our community and culture. But overall, it's great if you need to write an essay. It's really going to highlight all the grammar mistakes, spelling, formatting. Give you structure suggestions, give you tone and format. You can actually go ahead and say, okay, this paper is going to be academic, this and the audience is general education. Maybe this is for the professor, so it needs to be sound more professional. This is for a job, this is for friends. So you can actually set the tone, and that really sets the difference. And each year has really improved. But by far, the most important feature that they have is the plagiarism checker.
Yeah, plagiarism checker.
It saves a lot of time. You can find different plagiarism checkers out there, but I think Grammarly by far is the best one. You can actually get a report that from them to really verify that, hey, this is 100% original.
Well, talking actually about emails that I've used it a ton, there's another extension that I actually use for Gmail specifically. Which is Streak. It's basically this CRM that you get to have for your Gmail.
But let me ask you, hey, Matty, why would I, a very normal old student, college student, would need a CRM?
Well, let me tell you why. I mean, it makes total sense. Like, the thing that I think is phenomenal from this app is it lets you know when someone opened your mail, basically, which is, I mean, we all want that. I mean, Gmail, you're missing out. Like, we all want this feature. But Streak has it, and you can try it out for free.
So you're telling me, because this happened to me a lot, if you're working in a group assignment, and, you know, you send the emails, and you just know who read it and who didn't.
Yeah,
now you can actually know who did. So maybe reach out to someone like, hey, Todd, I saw that you didn't read my email. No, I did it. No, I know that you didn't for a fact because I have a streak. Got you, Todd. I got you, finally.
I can't say that I haven't used it that way.
No, I love it. And again, as I said before, I think this is one of those examples that it's an extension that you're not going to use a lot, but you're just going to use it for that specific task, and it's free. So why not to just go ahead, install it, and use it? Which takes me to the final entry in our list, which for me is my view. For me, in my experience, it's the citation generator that I liked using. Of course, you can find Citation Machine, Chegg, and plenty of different options out there, and most, if not all, are great. But my beep for me is the one that instantly gave me the citation.
Yeah, that's true. And it also have the option to download it. You have different bins, you can organize it. So
yeah. Oh, and I almost forget, you can also choose to save it on your bibliography directly within my bib. So maybe you scroll different, you visit 5-6 pages, you save all of them, then you go to your my bib website and there you have everything there already listed out.
So I mean, that's talking about saving time.
Talking about saving time, all right.